Hi dear student, this class I am going to discuss how to differentiate the definite integral, that is the Leibniz rule. Integral f of t dt, limits are from g of x to h of x. F of t is a continuous function. G of x and h of x, these two functions are differentiable. Then its differentiation is given by, in place of t we are substituting upper limit into upper limit differentiation, minus in place of t we are substituting lower limit into lower limit differentiation, that is Leibniz rule. Differentiation of definite integral, integral f of t dt, limits from g of x to h of x, what we have to do first? In place of t we have to substitute upper limit into upper limit differentiation, minus in place of t lower limit into lower limit differentiation, that is Leibniz rule. So that particular question application I am going to discuss, which is the question given in a previous year's IIT. This is the particular question: limit x tends to 0, limit x tends to 0. The question is given as integral 0 to x t into logarithm of 1 plus t divided by t power 4 plus 4 divided by x cube. That is the question. Same question I modified in this way. Now you can observe here, if you substitute upper limit, what happens? Numerator is becoming 0, denominator is also becoming 0. Whenever we are getting a 0 by 0 form, we can apply L'Hospital rule or not? Come on, apply L'Hospital rule. How to proceed in L'Hospital rule? Differentiate the numerator, differentiate the denominator. That's why we have to differentiate the numerator. When we are differentiating the numerator, we have to apply Leibniz rule. Come on, differentiate the numerator. That is equals to limit x tends to 0, in place of t we have to substitute upper limit into upper limit differentiation. That's why you will get x into logarithm of 1 plus x divided by x power 4 plus 4, in place of t upper limit substituted, upper limit differentiation. Similarly, minus in place of t we have to substitute lower limit. Lower limit is becoming 0, that's why no need to write. Whole divided by, we completed the differentiation of the numerator, we have to differentiate denominator. Denominator differentiation is x cube, differentiation is 3x square. Now this further simplification, we can write it as limit x tends to 0, logarithm of 1 plus x. Yes, because x cancel here, logarithm of 1 plus x into 3x into x power 4 plus 4, right? Because x cancel, that's why 3x into x power 4 plus 4. Again, apply the limits. In place of x, we are substituting 0. Again, we are getting a 0 by 0 form or not. So again, we can apply L'Hospital rule. Apply L'Hospital rule, that is equals to limit x tends to 0, log 1, that is differentiation, log of 1 plus x differentiation, 1 by 1 plus x divided by its differentiation, what happens? 3 into x power 5 differentiation, 5 into x power 4, next 3 4s are 12, 3x multiplied inside, 12x differentiation is 12. Now apply limit, in place of x we are substituting 0, then we will get the answer as 1 by 12. This is the previous year's question. So next, one more question is given like this: integral 0 to sin square x sin inverse of root 2 t dt, plus integral 0 to cos square x cos inverse of root 2 t dt. He is asking to find that value. So that is, I am saying this is the function, let us say f of x. He is asking to find f of x value. So for that, what I am doing is f dash of x I am finding. What is f dash of x? Same, we have to differentiate. For differentiation, we have to apply Leibniz rule. Come on, differentiate it. That is equals to integral 9. This is in place of t, we have to write sin square x into sin square x differentiation, 2 sin x into sin x differentiation cos x. In place of t, I substitute upper limit into upper limit differentiation, sin square x differentiation, 2 sin x cos x, minus second one is 0, sin inverse of 0 is 0 only. Next, plus the second part, cos inverse of cos x In place of t we are writing now cos square x differentiation is 2 times cos x into cos x differentiation is minus sin x. Now what happens? Both cancel because here sin inverse of sin x is x, here cos inverse of cos x is x. So here minus symbol, here plus symbol. We got f dash of x is equal to 0. F dash of x is equal to 0, we got means f of x is a constant function. That means we got f of x, this value must be constant. What is the constant we have to find out? Are f of x is equal to constant means f of 0 also same constant, f of 1 also same constant, f of 2 also same constant, f of pi by 4 also same constant. Sir, why you are taking f of pi by 4? The reason is, if you are taking x is equal to pi by 4, this becomes 1 by 2. This is also becomes 1 by 2. Limits are same. That's why. That is the reason. Limits are same. Then what happens? You know, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. That result we can use. That is the reason I am taking f of pi by 4. Now I am finding f of pi by 4 is equals to 0 to 1 by 2 sin inverse of root 2t plus cos inverse of root 2t dt. Agree or not? Because f of x is equal to this one. I am finding f of pi by 4. That means wherever x is there, in place of x, I am writing pi by 4. That's why 0 to 1 by 2. Here also 0 to 1 by 2. Same integral. That's why sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. So then we can write this one as integral 0 to 1 by 2. Pi by 2 into dt. That is equals to pi by 2 into t. Limits are from 0 to half. That is equals to pi by 4. You will get the answer. F of pi by 4, we got pi by 4. F of x is equal to constant means, f of pi by 4, we got pi by 4 means, that f of x, that means this value, this functional value, must be equal to pi by 4. That is the way. So another problem I am discussing here. This is the function. That function is a continuous function in open interval a comma b. And in open interval a comma b, this function maximum value is m and the minimum value is small m. That function maxima and minima values in a comma b interval is plus capital M is the maximum value and small m is the minimum value. Then integral a to b f of x dx, this integral value lies between m into b minus a and a small m into b minus a. So, because nothing, if this value f of x lies between capital M and small m means, apply integration both sides. Here also we are applying integration both sides. Here also we are applying integration both sides. Okay. So, whenever f of x is greater than or equal to g of x in the interval a comma b, then integral a to b f of x dx is also greater than or equals to integral a to b g of x. That's what I want to discuss. So that's why f of x lies between small m and capital M, then its integral lies between m into b minus a, because m is a constant here. Integration of dx is x, apply the limits, upper limit minus lower limit. Here also the same. So that's why whenever the function maximum value is m and minimum value is small m, then that integral value lies between these two, right? So that is another property based on inequalities in definite integral. Based on that, let us see one question. This is the question 1, 2, 3, square root of 3 plus x cube dx. That functional value lies between this functional value, that integral value lies between. That's what he is asking in the next question. Okay. Observe here, when x is equal, because you see, function, let us take the function as f of x is equal to 3 plus x cube. Its differentiation, what we are getting, f dash of x is equal to 3x square, which is greater than or equals to 0. F dash of x greater than or equal to 0 means what? The function is an increasing function. Array, the function is an increasing function. Function is an increasing function. Lower limit is 1. The upper limit is 3. That means at 1, it has a minimum value. At 3, it has a maximum value or not? So the function is an increasing function. Whether this is also an increasing function, this is also an increasing function. At 1 it has a minimum value, at 3 it has a maximum value. So what is its minimum value? We can say it as root over 3 plus x cube value. If you substitute 1, what happens? If you substitute 1, you will get greater than or equals to 2. If you substitute 3, what happens? Less than or equals to root 30. So this expression value lies between 2 and root 3. Then what we can write? Therefore, integral 1 to 3 dx lies between root 30 into 3 minus 1, whereas here 2 into 3 minus 1. So that is the way to proceed that particular question. Okay, so now integral 1 to 3 root of 3 plus x cube dx, maximum value is equals to 2 into root 30, minimum value is equals to 4. Right? So that is the discussion based on those two properties. First we discussed based on that property, and the second one we discussed based on this inequality. Okay, thank you very much.